For this example, we will predict the products, balance the chemical equation, then using a solubility table, we'll identify the solubility of each compound, then we'll find the complete ionic equation, and finally, we'll find the net ionic equation. All right, let's predict our products. So we're given our reactants here, and the concept of the inner with the inner and outer with the outer, what I mean by that is the inner elements will combine to form our product, and then so will the outer elements will combine to form our other product. So with the inner with the inner, we'll start off with lead and chlorine. You always want to put the positive charge, which is the metal, and then the negative charge, which is the non-metal, together. So always put the metal first, then the non-metal. And then we know that lead is a 2+ charge and chlorine is a -1 charge. So what will happen is this 2 is going to come down and go with our chlorine because that has to be our subscript. So our first compound or our first product will be lead chloride. Next, we're gonna do the outer with the outer, and we'll see that potassium and nitrate will combine. So you'll note that potassium has a +1 charge, nitrate has a -1 charge, and then our charges are completely balanced. So then our next product would be potassium nitrate. Let's balance this equation. When we're balancing chemical equations, I always like to put the elements on opposite sides. So I'll make one list of elements on the reactants and one list of elements on the products. Now, whenever you have like nitrate in this case, or any sort of polyatomic ion, I like to keep those intact because we only do this, by the way, if we have them the same on either side. So I'm gonna leave NO3 together because it makes it so much easier to balance. Now let's see how much of each element we have. So for potassium, there's only 1, chlorine, there's 1, lead, there's 1, and then nitrate, there's actually 2. And that's due to this little 2 subscript there. So I know there's actually 2 nitrates. Next, moving on to our products, there's only 1 potassium, and now there are 2 chlorines. And then next, there's 1 lead and 1 nitrate. Okay, so it doesn't matter the order as to which element you want to start balancing first. I'm going to start off with chlorine. So since on our product side there are 2 chlorine and then on our reactant there's only 1, I'm going to place a 2 in front of that entire compound of KCl. And then what will happen, it's like you're distributing, and now we have 2 potassiums and 2 chlorines, but everything else remains the same. So what's left to balance is that nitrate. Now I'll put a 2 in front of potassium nitrate, and once again, this is going to distribute. So we'll have 2 potassiums and 2 nitrates, and then everything else stays the same. Now we're completely balanced. Now let's move on to identifying our solubility of every single compound. So whenever we're looking at solubility, we're gonna have to look at a solubility table. Now, what I like to do when I'm predicting a solubility of, let's say, any sort of compound, in this specific case of chlorine, of KCl, I like to look at chlorine first. And I'm gonna see, where is chlorine on my solubility table? Well, that's a halogen, and those are typically soluble with the exception of these 3 metals. Now, since potassium is in group 1, that's always gonna be soluble. So I know that this compound must be soluble, making it aqueous. And then I'll keep going. So now to our next reactant, I'll look at the last portion of the compound, so that nitrate. And then nitrate is right here in our solubility table. It's always gonna be soluble because there are no exceptions to our rule. So we know this, again, would be aqueous. Moving on. We'll see that same sort of case here where we have NO3, and that's nitrate again. Nitrate has no exceptions, so it's going to be soluble, which means it's aqueous. And then lastly, we'll see we have chlorine again, but you note that lead is one of those exceptions. So since it is an exception to that rule, that means this must be a solid. Now that we've identified all of the solubilities for every single one of these compounds, let's write our complete ionic equation, which is also known as our total ionic equation. So whenever we're looking at a complete ionic equation, what we're going to do is for all the compounds that are aqueous and only the ones that are aqueous, you will break apart those compounds into their separate ions. Remember, an ion is just an element with a charge. So anytime we'll see a solid, like in this case, you're not going to do anything to that solid, but leave it alone and leave it intact. So let's start breaking everything apart. So our first aqueous compound is KCl. And I'm going to break this apart into its separate ions. And we'll see there's actually two potassiums and two chlorines, because I want you to think of this two is really distributing into both. So that's why we have two potassiums, and potassium has a plus one charge. We'll also state that it's aqueous. Next, we'll see that there are two chlorines. Chlorine has a negative one charge, that's also aqueous, and we'll move on to our second reactant. So this compound is still aqueous, that's why we're able to break it apart into its ions, and we'll see, okay, we have lead that has a 2+ charge and that's also aqueous, but we'll note that there are two nitrates here because of this 2 subscript that we had initially. So that's why we have two NO3s with that negative one charge, and it's also aqueous. And lastly, this is our last compound that's aqueous that will break apart. So we'll have two potassiums with a positive charge and it's aqueous, and two nitrates with its negative charge and it's also aqueous. Now with this solid, we're gonna leave it alone. Don't break that apart. So we never break any solids or liquids. And then for aqueous is the only one that you're gonna break apart. Now let's write our complete ionic equation by adding all of your reactants together and adding all of your products together. So we'll see that our complete ionic equation would be this big old long thing. And what we're gonna do next to finally get our net ionic equation is you're gonna cancel out any like terms or any like ions. So these are known as spectator ions. A spectator ion means we will see that on the reactant and on the product side. So our spectator ions in this case would be potassium, because we have potassium on our reactants and our product side, so those cancel, plus our other spectator ion would be our nitrate, since those are also cancel out. Now, let's look at this, okay? So for your net ionic equation, you're always gonna have the ions as your reactants that are needed to form your solid. So we needed chlorine, two chlorines to be exact, and we needed lead to form our final product or that final solid. So those two must be added together to give you your net ionic equation, and that would be our final answer. All right, so this was a packed example, I know. If you guys need more help with solubility and understanding how to read a solubility table, make sure to check out my latest video and make sure to download your solubility table. The link is in the description box. Now, I know that there's a lot to all of these concepts, and at times you may feel like giving up. But a lot of times when you feel that way, you are closer to succeeding than you really think. Trust me, I've been through it. So keep moving forward, guys, and I'll see you in the next video.